stated that again they were found. They were found safe. And again, 1.4 miles away from their house, and this is rugged territory. This is extreme environment. And how they were out there for 44 hours is pretty amazing. But it shows the resilience of people that actually grew up in this community. These girls were definitely a survival story to tell. So we're looking forward to hearing.
Did they say anything to the search and rescue crew when they first were reunited out there? What was their first words to them?
So we don't have any details on that yet. We will be debriefing all the people involved in this and getting that information for the Bobby.
Did the two girls, did they have some sort of training?
So the information we gathered is that they were trained through 4-H, through outdoor survival, and we believe that that did pay a part, but we're only speculating right now. We'll wait to interview them and understand at the start what the last 44 hours was like.
Can you describe what it was like for your folks to tell the mother the good news and how that went down?
Lieutenant Friendly?
Yeah, I've been dealing with the mom for a couple days here. I got the privilege of calling her and telling her what they're doing. They got both of us. Obviously, a mother of two children, and they've been missing for this long, and a lot of stuff that's in her head. So, yeah, she was she melted on the phone. We had to hang up.
Good job.
What kind of medical needs do you have?
Number one concern is dehydration. Being out there for so long, so our first responders out there, we do know that they had fresh, warm clothing that they put on the girls, that they gave them water, and the initial assessment was that they were dehydrated, they were cold, but they were well, and so that's our first concern, making sure that they get hydrated, that they get a meal, and they get warm. So they're addressing all those needs right now.